Hey guys, welcome back to Streaming Nerds, and today I'm back with another video. And in this video we're gonna unbox the Fire TV stick. As you can see, I just received my Fire TV stick, and before this I was primarily relying on my Android TV box, which you can see right here, but now I have my Fire stick also. So today we're gonna unbox this Fire stick and we're gonna see what is inside, and then I will also show you how you can connect it to your TV, to your monitor. So I'll be showing that after we unbox it. And as you can see, this is the box that I received from Amazon, and the Fire TV stick is inside it. And as you can see on the side of this box, we have voice search, Dolby audio, 802.11 AC MIMO Wi-Fi. This Fire TV stick supports full HD. And then as you can see, it has a quad core processor, pretty fast. And it is showing what's included: Amazon Fire TV stick, second generation, a voice remote, two AAA batteries. So you don't have to go out and shop for batteries. It's included in this box. Power adapter, which we will use to supply power to our Fire TV stick. Then there's a USB cable. And then there is an HDMI extender cable. So you need a high speed internet for this Fire TV stick to work properly. Otherwise you may get buffering if you have a slow internet connection, so make sure you have a high speed internet connection. So let's go ahead and let's open this up. And as you can see, there is a tape on this box, so I'm gonna remove this. Okay, then we're gonna open it like this. Okay, and there's a black box inside, I think. Yep, so this is the box that is inside this box, and let me open this up. Okay, so first let's get this out and see what this is. Looks like a manual, and yes, it is a manual for setting up the device for first time. So it has got all the instructions, as you can see. So this is the manual, and Fire TV stick with remote. This is some important information. I'll keep it here. And then let me take out this. What's this? This is a USB cable. As you can see, the one end of this will go into the USB, and the other end probably will go into the Fire TV stick. So we will check that out in a bit. And the other thing that we have in here, okay, this is an HDMI extender cable. So if your TV is very close to the wall, you can fit this HDMI extender. This side will go into the TV and the other side can drop like this, and then you can fit in the Fire TV stick in here. So it can be very useful for those who have the TV very close to the wall. So the next thing is the power adapter, as you can see. Then you can see here we have the two AAA batteries from Amazon. This is Amazon Basics, and they are pretty good in quality. The next thing is the Amazon Fire TV stick. So it's inside this cover. Let me take it out. And you can see this is the Amazon Fire TV stick. Looks pretty neat. And after that, we have the remote, I think. Yeah, and we can take it out from here. So this is all empty now. So this is the remote. So this is the voice remote that Amazon is supplying with the Fire TV stick second generation. So this remote understands a lot of voice commands, and I will be making another video tutorial in which I will show you how you can use this remote very efficiently. So this is what comes with a Fire TV stick. All these things were packed inside that box. So we have the voice remote, we have the Amazon Fire TV stick, we have the two AAA batteries, we have the HDMI extender, we have the power adapter, and we have the USB cable. So let's first put the batteries inside the remote. So this is the voice remote, and I'm gonna flip it. And now you need to drag this to the top. Okay, and you can see it has come out. I'm gonna pick it up, and you can see there is a space for the batteries. And on the remote, you can see the plus sign is at the top. So I will look for the plus sign on the battery as well. It is towards the top. So I'm gonna put it like this, and the plus sign should be to the top as shown in this cavity. So again, I need to make sure that the plus sign is towards the top. So I have put in the batteries, and now I'm gonna put the cover back. And as you can see, we have successfully put in the batteries. And as you can see, I have the Fire stick in my hand now, and if you flip it a little bit, you can see there is the power port. You need to input the power cable in here. We have the power cable that has been supplied to us, and if you can see, one end of it goes exactly inside this. So I'm gonna put this in because we need to supply power to this device in order for it to work. So we have attached the power source here on the Amazon Fire TV stick, and this USB connector can go into any USB port. If there is a USB port on your TV, plug this in there and you don't need the adapter. But if you don't have the USB port on your TV, then of course you need to use the adapter. You can see there is the USB port on this adapter, and now I'm gonna connect these two. So if I insert it here, it connects very well. And of course after that you need to connect this on a wall socket, and then it will supply power to this Amazon Fire TV stick. And now we're ready to connect this to our TV or to our monitor. And I'm not going to connect this on a wall socket. I'm going to use my Android box and I'm going to plug in my USB connector to the USB port on the Android box. So let me do that. And as you can see, I have connected the power source to our Fire TV stick. And now I'm going to connect my Fire TV stick to our TV, or you can also connect it to your monitor. So my monitor is right here, and we're going to connect our Amazon Fire TV stick to this monitor. And let me flip my monitor. And now if you're able to see, there is the HDMI port. And if your monitor or your TV is too close to the wall, then you can of course use the HDMI extender. So I will use the HDMI extender for demonstration purposes. And as you can see, I have connected my HDMI extender, and now I will connect my Fire TV stick. So here is my Fire TV stick, and let me connect it to the HDMI extender. As you can see, so that goes in here. So there you go, I have connected my Fire TV stick, and there should be no space. If you're using a Fire TV stick, you can see there is no space between the extender and the Fire TV stick. And I'm gonna flip this now, and we're gonna see what is coming up on the screen. So as you can see, the Amazon logo has appeared on the screen. And now here on the screen, it is telling us to press the play and pause button, which is this button. So I'm gonna press it. And then it says choose your language. So I'm gonna select English, United States. And for OK, you need to use the middle round button. Okay, it's showing scanning for networks. And now it's showing connect to your network, and it has shown up my networks. I'm clicking OK on my network name, and it tells me to enter the password. So I'm gonna enter the password. So I have entered my password, and now I'm gonna click on connect. So this is the connect option right here. So I'm gonna press OK now. So it's showing connecting to the network, and it shows connection successful. And then it shows checking for updates, and it's downloading the latest software. So we need to wait a little while for it to complete the update. And now it's showing installing the latest software. Please do not unplug the power cable during the update. So we need to wait a little while. So the installation of the update has been done, and the Amazon logo appeared, and now it's going to start the Fire TV stick again, and you can see the Fire TV stick logo now. So now as you can see, it is showing us optimizing system storage and applications, and this is going to take around 10 minutes to complete. So guys, we need to have some patience here, and we need to wait 10 minutes more. So just wait. And now as you can see that the optimization of the apps has been done, and it shows Amazon Fire TV stick is registered to SHA. Yes, continue as SHA. Change my account. So I'm going to click on yes, continue as SHA, which is my account. So I'm pressing OK on my remote. And then it shows me this screen where it says save Wi-Fi passwords to Amazon. Wi-Fi passwords entered on this device will be saved to your Amazon account. And I'm going to click yes. And then it shows the screen where it says enable parental controls, but I will not enable it right now. And we're going to cover the parental controls in a separate video. So I'm going to click on no, which is the second option, pressing OK on my remote. So this is the intro video that is being shown to me right now, so I can understand how to use the Amazon Fire TV stick. So I'm going to fast forward it. And now we're on the main home screen of your Fire TV stick. So we have successfully set up our Amazon Fire TV stick. So from the gist of it, I can say that the home screen and the interface looks really nice. And as I said, I'll be covering everything in the coming up video tutorials. So guys, that was the unboxing and the setup of your Fire TV stick. So there will be a lot of cool stuff coming up in my channel with regard to Amazon Fire TV stick. So stay tuned to my channel, guys. And if you think I'm creating useful videos for you guys, please hit the like button on this video. And also, do not forget to subscribe to my channel. And guys, I'll be back with more awesome videos. So stay tuned to my channel. And I love you all. Bye-bye.